going to the mount position, when you have side control, what I want to do is I want to make sure that my hands are connected. Hand is going to be underneath the head. I'm looking at the back of the knuckles. It gives me a better flexibility. It's almost like doing a reverse curl as opposed to a regular curl. I have more connection with my forearm and my bicep on her neck and her chin by having my hand turn palm down instead of turn palm up. Thumbless grip. Elbow's going to be into the side. I'm going to have my knee high, preventing her from being able to take her elbow, her right elbow, and bring it to the ground, putting in a frame. My chin is going to be tucked, head is going to be down. I have good pressure with my shoulder into her jaw. What I'm going to do now is I'm bringing my right knee is going to come across her belt line. Because my knees are so spread out, it's going to be hard for me, unless you can do a split, for me to bring my right knee up right now and go into this position. It's really a stretch. So what I do is slightly before I go in, I'll take my left knee, I'll bring it down slightly so that I can make my connection to come all the way over into the top mount position. Okay, so that's going to be the easy shape transition going from the side control to the mount. Slide the knee across the belt line. I'm not stepping over with my leg, so I'm not coming over this way where she can trap, okay, or block. So I'm going here, I'm going knee to the belt line. So it goes right up the side of her hip, across, and then I stretch here. As I'm stretching down, I'm pushing my knee to the ground. I'm taking my right elbow and I'm bringing my right elbow up into the air, opening up that side of her body so that I can easy go to the pass. And now I'm in my mount position.